Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Azure Seas of Nita. And welcome aboard the light cruiser Medusa here in the designer mode. Yeah, I've been recently working out a few flaws of this design, and now I think I've reached a point where its performance is no longer impeded by any minor issues. Yeah. Well, before we head off into the adventure mode, I would like to do an announcement. It may happen that you come across an FTD video of me in the future, where you probably can't understand anything I'm saying. Well, that's because FTD videos in German will be returning soon to this channel, now that I have a little more time to record. Yeah. You know, I'm also doing German content of FTD, apparently. Ah, I may have forgotten that. Okay, then. Anyway, enough of the introduction. Let's head into the adventure mode. And there we are. Back again to the all-familiar oceans. Yeah, I have, rearranged our adventure carrier here a bit. You can see now that the interceptor prototype number 2 has now been designated a space here on the flight deck. And this is primarily of two reasons. Because, first and foremost, since it isn't flying around anymore, it isn't using up any materials, and subsequently, well, fuel. And also because I have finished testing this interceptor and I've deemed it a successful design and thus will permanently integrate it into my forces. So, what's next? How about a battle? An enemy has been spotted. Launch all aircraft and let's see what we have here. A particle accelerator cannon and something is heading towards us at rather high speeds. Looks to me like this is a wide flare design. This is one I haven't seen yet. Hang on a second. What are you before we completely destroy you, that is? You are a pandemonium. Okay. I always thought you looked different. Oh, anyway. Pandemonium then. Yeah. White flare is what's it called? Melee vehicles are particularly dangerous in this mode. Since well, it may happen that you lose track of what's happening in during the fight when so much is going on, and then there was a flayed soul, or here a pandemonium, suddenly approaching right next to your ship, or well, suddenly appearing right next to your adventure craft. Yeah, that is an unpleasant and rather painful surprise there. Okay, but the pandemonium has been dealt with, so we're all good. Oh, by the way, if you're wondering, I have finished the design of the Tremonia cruiser here, and I've put up the design on the workshop, by the way. So yeah. Though, please bear in mind, this is a very, very simple design of mine, and basically just me trying out better ways to build APS guns. Actually, saying that now, I may have to retrofit this one. Yeah, that's a bit more expensive than before, but hey. There we go. Much better. Also, I've done something else. I have set up the main propulsion components of this adventure carrier in a way that once we are out of combat, it's their thrust is reduced by 50%, so that while we are out of combat, the fleet here around us has a chance to catch up with the adventure carrier. Once an enemy has been spotted, however, we will accelerate to 100% of our engine output. I think that's a reasonable change. All right then, looking for more enemies. Oh, while it's so silent all of a sudden, I have read a few comments under the last video. Some of them were stating that this fragment is rather overpowered. Yes, I have to agree and at the same time disagree. For you see, there is a reason why this is so overpowered. You've probably seen in the last episode, once this fragment gets into melee range and starts hacking away at the enemy, it cannot be stopped. Or, well, it can be stopped, but it's very, very difficult to do so. However, there's a catch to that. The fragment is not equipped with any defensive systems. And while, yes, I acknowledge melee weapons and melee particle cannons here in this game are extremely powerful, and the fragment is certainly a formidable force, but it has to close the distance first. And on its way to the target, it can be hit by any number of weaponry, ranging from torpedoes, well, particle cannons, APS shells, you name it. And since its armor is actually fairly light and it has no defensive systems, it can be stopped in its tracks rather abruptly. Yeah, I guess that means that it's actually not that overpowered, I would say. Ooh, oh, good hit here on what is this? The Valkyrie? No, that's a Longinus. Okay. The Valkyrie looks different. Yeah. We're getting all kinds of white flare vehicles recently. I wonder what's happening. Oh, by the way, the primary objective of this episode is to collect enough resources to once again fill the adventure carrier's cargo hold and then move on to the next, yeah, to the next difficulty level. Well, until then, I guess I'll just stay here and collect more resources. Hang on. We are experiencing a little bit of deja vu here, I think. I have met this foe before. In fact, this is where our little fragment submarine comes from. The Iridianus, with its complement of flying fragments. Back for round two, I see. Oh, well then, let's see how we handle this one. I'm pretty sure we are able to defeat it. Well, I say that now, but we may end up losing a few units. Though the Iridianus itself doesn't have that many and that powerful weapon systems. A few particle accelerator cannons, yes. But nothing that could put a, well, make a dent in maybe even the Aegis destroyer or little escort there. And there's the speedy boy, the missile artillery hydrofoil. Yeah, pretty long designation. But an apt description for this unit. Okay then. Yeah, I see the red tracers here are from the Tremonia. She's mostly firing heat and hash. Not a ship purpose-built for outright destroying other units, like making block damage or armor damage, but rather dismantling them from the inside out. If that's how you want to put it. Fragment versus fragment. But I'm afraid, yeah, you're never going to reach them that way. Nope, you are not. Hey, but at least you're trying. And here it comes. Oh, and thank you to whoever made the comment under the last video suggesting that I speed up the traverse of these particle cannon beams. I have done so. I have tested it, however, to see if it still can apply a reasonable amount of damage. because I don't want to speed up the particle cannon beams that much so that they don't destroy a block outright they are hovering over. So, yeah. Need to keep that in mind. Okay then. We have dealt with the Iridianus and oh, there's a collision. The Medusa has collided with our adventure carrier.
Ach.
Come on now. This is not what I wanted. Well, the collision, that is, not the destruction of the Iridianus. Once again, the seas have fallen silent. Alright, things are getting interesting again. First of all, we have a Grey Talon airship here that just spawned, a Smaug. It has released a little fighter craft. This is, I think, a Hellraven, if I'm correct. Yes, it is. A Hellraven. And there's a Caspian around here as well. A Lightning Hood's laser vehicle, modeled after a certain ground effect vehicle. So then, let's see how this plays out. The Caspian is instantly engaging the Smaug. Well, fine by me. So I will just help out the Smaug for now, since...
engaging now.
There we go. The Caspian with its laser is a far greater threat to my aircraft than the Smaug, to be honest. Just kill the Caspian for now, and we'll deal with the Smaug later, I guess. Especially since the Caspian is also dropping torpedoes. That is something I do not wish to encounter. It even has lamps. Okay then. Oh dear. Looks like the Smaug received a devastating hit there, and it has lost stability. Yep, that's it. Goodbye, Smaug. We hardly knew you. Alright, I need to get my bearings once again. I think the interception systems are focusing on the torpedoes right now, fired by the Caspian. And the fleet has... the fleet has fallen into formation. We are now firing all of our weapons on the Caspian, it seems. Just the only unit remaining. Though sadly, not hitting it that much, since it's moving around very, very fast and erratically. Well, save for missiles, that is. There we go. Problem dealt with. Not quite. There is still something here that the Smaug has released earlier. A Hellraven. Well, I'm sure this is no problem after all. Yep, there we go. Bombed it to bits. There we go. Done. Oh, by the way, my interceptor prototype number 2 has now received a correct designation. This is the PF-315 Phantom. Well, or Phantom in English. Prototype number 1 is still waiting for its testing cycle to complete. I'll hold off on this one. I have noticed a few flaws with the design that I have to correct yet. There's one. It tends to lose altitude rather quickly when doing very sharp turns. May have to correct this issue at some point. Oh boy, what do we have here? I was just getting bored, because nothing happened. No units spawned, no foe appeared, and I was just cruising along these endless seas of Nita when suddenly there is a Twin Guard unit. What do we have here? A Juggernaut. Okay, first things first, as with all of these Twin Guard mechs,
Engaging now.
Deal with the base plate first, and this will stop the torso from being repaired, basically. And yeah, of course. Of course, that's a huge missile. Naturally. Oh dear. Here it comes. Pain and suffering no one asked for. Okay. Yeah, just deal with it. Hang on. Have we intercepted it yet? No, because there's no need to. It has just run out of fuel. What a shame. Oh, by the way, I'm heading towards this red portal here. I've decided to simply go into the next difficulty level, even if I don't have gathered that many resources yet. Anyway, here's the Juggernaut, currently being assaulted by, I think, most part of my fleet. Yeah. See, the thing with these Twin Guard mechs is that, you can see it here, once the body gets damaged, it's being repaired by repair units placed in this, what's it called, the base plate section. Since the body of the mech itself is being held in place by a tractor beam and thus can be repaired by its mother vehicle. So, there is another missile that has been launched. I have missed it apparently. Oh, no, there it is. Okay, it appears we have dealt with it. Hang on, the carrier has taken damage. Oh yeah, quite a bit actually. Yep, it's coming from the Juggernaut. Of course it is. Deal with it. Deal with it now. Okay. I may need something with a little bit more firepower in the future. I'm thinking of replacing the Tremonia cruiser with something else. And also, I'm currently figuring out to find a way to bring in some airships into adventure mode without having them constantly being airborne, of course. I was thinking of a small kind of carrier unit which does not need any resources and carries an airship on a tractor beam and releases it once an enemy has been detected. Yeah, you can do that. Just a tiny helicopter actually carrying a massive airship. Just don't question it, okay? Hey, there we go. Resources. Gimme. Since I apparently lost a few resources, or going to lose a few resources when repairing the melon seed, our Grand Command carrier has taken a little bit of damage here and there. But nothing, it appears, has breached the armor so far. Sure, it has been damaged just a tiny bit, but there is no internal damage here, as far as I can see. Okay, save for the torpedo tubes, but they are very close to the outer armor belt anyway. Da. Alright then. Continue to set a course for this red portal. And let's see what awaits us in the next difficulty plane. Also, repairs should probably be underway right now. Alright, here we go. New difficulty level and new enemies await us. Let's see. We are currently on warp difficulty 55. Alright, and I've fixed this interceptor now. It's no longer falling into the water when making tight turns. So, yeah, there's that. Alright. Let's set a new course.
Form up and fly with
fleet move is still engaged. How about we head over there? Come on now. No, wait. We are out of combat, so half speed ahead, I think. Once more, an Eridianus carrier has spawned and is now on approach towards our fleet. Well, and it's still coming under anti-aircraft fire. Yeah, I suppose this won't be a problem to deal with. I've dealt with this kind of unit before, and it shouldn't be that difficult to bring it down. In fact, here we go. AI dead. Now, all that's left to deal with are these little fragments here. I don't know if I could grab me another one of these. The last one was poor luck, to be honest. But yeah. Tiny little fragments that are surprisingly not that well armored, actually. And now it's a big pile of scrap. Okay, I need the resources. I need them now. We are on a higher difficulty level and... yeah. Where are my enemies? Am I doing something wrong here? I don't know, actually. I don't know what determines the spawn rate and spawn probability of enemies in adventure mode. That is something completely unknown to me yet. And oh, by the way, I have spawned in another Phantom Interceptor. Also assigned it here to the flight deck. And now we have two of those, with our Interceptor prototype number one still circling overhead. Somewhere. There it is. There it is. Well, ask and you shall receive. I wanted new enemies, and here is a new enemy, a new enemy, in fact. This is the Latobius. You may not find it in the vanilla version of Nita anymore. It is an older design by the Great Talons, and I have refurbished it a bit and made it functional once again, and also added it to this version of Nita, which is, as I mentioned previously, an edited instance. So yeah, the Latobius. Here we go. Already releasing smoke and thus making the targeting laser of the Aegis Destroyer next to useless. Very nice. This probably also means that my laser weaponry won't be of much use here against this type of airship. Although it is moving quite quickly, so yeah, the higher the speed of a unit, the less effective smoke becomes. Oh boy. Oh boy, here we go. That's a lot of damage, actually. That's a little bit too much damage for the Latobius to handle, but it is still airborne nonetheless. Oh, I can't seem to see any weaponry that's still functional. No, it doesn't seem like it. It's holding up surprisingly well, especially against all these EMP strikes. One interceptor trying to tail it, and yeah, breaking off at the last second. Ah. Okay, now it has switched broadsides, or is it just out of control? I don't know. Anyway, the Latobius. It's, well, I would say a medium Great Talons design. Not that difficult to deal with, but you shouldn't underestimate it either. Yeah. He says, but then throws an entire fleet against it. Of course, it is in no way proportionate. And not the best situation to show this unit's full combat potential. I recognize that, yes. There we go! Defeated. Okay, everyone back to the carrier and let's wait until the next surprise spawns. Okay, so I was sitting here, relaxing a bit, thinking of ways to improve this carrier, when suddenly I heard that the main guns on this carrier, the CBC Melon Seed, started turning. What could have spawned in, I wonder? Oh, I wonder what could have spawned in. Looks airplane-y, and it's my strategic bomber, the Rock. Yeah. Totally not inspired by a unit from a certain RTS game I very much like. No, certainly not. Well then, let's see how this goes. Well, it is equipped with smoke dispensers. No, smoke deployers. So, I wonder which unit it's going to go for. Though, it has to accelerate first, it seems. Yeah, the Rock is a slow, heavy armored, but incredibly easy to hit bomber. Yeah, it doesn't even have any defensive systems against interceptors or aircraft. It's very much purpose-built to basically bomb ground targets. That doesn't look like a ground target there. Okay then. And yeah. We've hit it. It has lost stability. And I think that's it. Or is it? Or is this just some kind of fancy maneuver it's pulling here? No, I'm fairly sure, certain it has lost all stability now and it's going to plummet into the depths of Nita. Actually Nita, but not really Nita. Ah, what a shame. What a shame. Yeah, it looks like I need to adjust the local weapon controller in there. It's releasing its bombs way too early, I'm afraid. And against the wrong targets as well. Still, a unit that is, should only be deployed if you have air superiority. Or you are certain that there are no other very strong units on the field that can deal with this one. Oh well, such is life, I guess. Oh, yep, yeah, here we go. Kamikaze onto the Medusa. Come on. Do it. Make my day. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. No? What a shame. Anyway. We have defeated the Rock and... what are you firing at? Hang on. What's this? Ah. That's just a plunderer. Nothing special. Nothing to see here. Yeah. Let's get back to the actual battle, which is between the fleet and the Rock. Not, Dwayne the Rock Johnson and, not Alcatraz either. Yeah, sorry, I know. Okay. Have we succeeded now in taking down this unit? Yeah, it appears so. There it is, despawning. Yep. Very nice. Let's just speed up this process and take a look at our radar. I'm seeing only one hostile contact left out here, and it's this plunderer, apparently. This shouldn't be a great deal, actually. This should not be very difficult to deal with. You missed. I am disappointed. And here are the torpedoes coming up from underneath. Very deadly this. I achieved this, by the way, by setting the ballast tanks on all torpedoes to its negative maximum. Well, wouldn't that be a minimum? Anyway, -5, I guess it's the setting, or -0.5. Points. And thus torpedoes are constantly forced underwater and actually have to actively steer up to reach their target, which makes them kinda come up below the target and strike the bottom of the hull. Very effective, I might add. Very effective indeed. Any more contacts? Nope. Okay then. Well, I guess this is it for now. I hope you have enjoyed this episode on the endless seas of Nita, and I am the Heidsmeister saying goodbye, and until next time, when we'll continue to gather more resources, and next time we'll be ready to spawn in a new unit. I wonder what this is going to... Hey, I mean, come on. I was sitting 1 hour here without anything spawning. Now that I'm doing the outro, you throw a unit. Ah, come on. Okay. Let's delay that one. This is white flares from the looks of it. Very spiky. Very edgy. And ooh, a slasher. Excuse me. Let's delay the outro for a bit and deal with this one here first. The Slasher. Ah, well, that's funny. This is the unit I tested the Medusa against in the designer before I started recording this episode. Yeah, looks like it's back for round two. Let's see, what do we have here? Are these torpedoes? Ah, there it is. Yeah, I remember now. This particle accelerator cannon. Oh, I didn't see it at first because it was hidden underwater. Very sneaky. But yeah, since particle cannons aren't affected by water at all, this is actually a really nice way to do some damage without being hit immediately by, well, incoming shells, I guess. Well, it's still firing back. It has acquired a command carrier as a target, I think. Oh, yeah, there we go. Yep, that's a big hit. I could see the Brock confetti there in the distance. Not very pleasant. Yippee! Zap! Haha. Yeah. That's it with your turret. It has been silenced by a sudden missile. Suddenly there was a missile. Ah, I hope this slasher here provides me with a large injection of resources so that I may spawn this unit right at the start of the next episode. So, spoiler alert, it's going to be an airship. Yeah, I talked about it earlier, about the way to basically make airships viable in adventure mode without having them being constantly airborne. And yeah, we'll see how that works in the next episode. So then, Slasher, you have fought valiantly while also looking great. A combination I'm quite fond of. But I'm afraid your journey ends here. Hey, was that a bounce? Excuse me? I accept no bounces here. Ech. Well then. Here comes the fragment. Maybe we'll get a little bit of melee pack action before the end of this episode. The true end, mind you. Yes, I won't let any more units disturb me. Yeah, sure. Torpedo missed. There we go. Melee particle cannons. And yeah, the fragment, once it has close distance to the unit, it is quite strong though, isn't it? Though I can see that these beams may be moving too fast. I was thinking about making the angle of movement a little bit wider, but since I have recessed the lenses inside this vehicle here a bit, I fear this may not be possible, otherwise the fragment would damage itself. Are we done now? No more foes? Yes? No? Okay. Right then, you know the drill, Heizmeister, which is I, Associates of Nita. Yes, but actually no. I hope I see you next time. Goodbye!